Hello friends, this is Srikanth from Road Trip in India, also with the name Travel with Srikanth, and welcome to my first vlog with a voiceover today. And we are going to talk about Hamsaldevi Beach in Krishna district of Andhra Pradesh. I have been here a couple of times due to the proximity it has with my native place near Guntur. Hamsaldevi Beach is easily accessible by road from Hyderabad and is a breeze to drive to this pristine beach. The first time around I have visited Hamsaldevi Beach was in daytime, starting at around 7 o'clock from Hyderabad and reaching Hamsaldevi Beach roughly around 3 o'clock in the afternoon. On my return journey, I started back around 4:30 after spending an hour and a half at the beach and the surrounding places to reach Hyderabad around 12 o'clock in the midnight. The road between Hyderabad to Hamsaldevi is a mix of national highway and state highway, with the national highway being a four-lane highway until Vijayawada. A bit of construction activity is going on and I'm sure that will be complete by mid next year at all the stretches, including the flyovers that are being constructed. You would then merge onto the inner ring road as you enter Vijayawada near Kollapudi to come towards Gavarnapet and Gannavaram road. And then you will be diverting your route towards Avanigadda and Koduru before heading towards Hamsaldevi Beach. There is also an alternative route that you could take, but you would need to go into Vijayawada and traverse through all the traffic of Vijayawada before finally hitting this road. The Avanigadda Hamsaldevi Beach Vijayawada road is very serene, with irrigation canal and fields on one side, with occasional villages coming in on one side of the road to Krishna River on the other side of the road. And believe me, you would be awestruck when you are traveling on this route. The distance between Vijayawada to Hamsaldevi is a little over 100 kilometers and can be covered in a duration of 1.5 to 2 hours, owing to the speed breakers and farmers using the same route in the morning while going to their fields. An interesting fact to all of you is to particularly the people who follow Tollywood, is Jai Jai Nikki Nayaka, a movie, a Telugu movie, was shot at this very beach along with a few titles on a drone. Also known as a Triveni Sagar Sangamam, as River Krishna meets Bay of Bengal. And if you venture to the length of the beach onto your left, you would see three colors of water converging towards the sea, and that would be a view to really behold. A quick reminder is about the facilities that this beach has. This being a pristine beach, not much explored by tourists, is only frequented by locals, and those who only have information about this beach probably from known circles are the people who frequent this beach from time to time. And that would give us a very interesting question of amenities which are next to none at this place, and I'm hopeful that Andhra Pradesh Tourism would come up with something very soon to tap into the tourism potential that this place has. You would probably have a few ice cream vendors in the morning and the evening, and a few hawkers who are selling in a few munching snacks. However, I would strongly recommend you to carry ample water and food along with you, as the nearest town, Machilipatnam, is around 20 kilometers away from this place, and Avanigadda, which is again around 25 kilometers away from this place. And the nearest city would be Vijayawada, which is around 100 kilometers. Coming to what you could explore at the beach. The beach has tight sand, and that is some good news for people who actually love off-roading. And if you have a SUV or a 4x4 vehicle with you, then this is the beach for you. Here you could drive on the beach, splashing the water as it comes to the shores. And don't be going a bit deep, because once you're stuck there, you would probably need someone from Koduru or Avanigadda coming in to rescue you with a tractor. Also, for people who are a bit devotional, there is an old Venugopalaswamy temple dating back to the Chola dynasty, and is one of the 108 Vishnu temples available in today's world. An interesting fact is a few friends have camped at this place, Hamsaldevi Beach, last year in 2019, and have shared that they did not face any problem whatsoever staying overnight at the place. And the only recommendation that they have is the camping could happen a bit far from the shore of the beach, so that the tides don't hit you hard. I've also heard that this place around Hamsal Devi Beach is a reserve forest area, and one recommendation that I would have is to definitely check with the authorities either in Avanigadda or the fisheries department that's there at Hamsal Devi to see if you could camp or if they have any tips that you could probably follow to have a wonderful camping trip without any hiccups at the wonderful beach here in Hamsal Devi. One pro tip that I would give you is based on my experience, and it is about if you're not comfortable staying on the beach but you would still want to have a wonderful sunrise experience at Hamsal Devi, you could probably stay at Vijayawada, and roughly around 4 o'clock you could start off on your trip to Hamsal Devi to just be in time for a wonderful sunrise experience, and I'm sure you would not be disappointed. thanks for stopping by. Travel with Srikanth and Road Trip in India is an effort from my side to capture my travelogues as I travel one highway at a time. And do visit my blog at traveldiaries.vacations for more finer details on various destinations that I have traveled in India and abroad and could help you plan your future vacations. If you like my video post, do subscribe and like the video. Also do hit on the bell icon to be updated of the future videos that I will be posting. Thank you for watching and safe travels in these tough times.